unable to see your thing. Okay. Okay, Rupal, Mishra, Sahil, and company. Yes. Monica Sharma, good afternoon. Are you able to get me? Okay. इधर तो आ रहा है. ओके. Are you able to get me now? Is the audio okay? Now clear. Okay. Thank you. Right, guys. So, this is about myself. Quick introduction. I'm Group Captain Rajesh Pandey, an Air Force veteran, alumnus of National Defense Academy with over 31 years of service. Been a former interviewing officer, over 4,000 selection interviews, former head training institute, DIPR, trained senior officers from the services as interviewing officers, overseen training of GTOs and psychologists posted at SSBs, trainer and an interview consultant. So today we are going to, now for whom all is this a dream? Right, so this is a dream destination, right? Audio and video, okay, fine. So this is the picture of Chedwood Hall, which I have personally taken. Okay. Sumedh Lakar, Monica Sharma, Sanam Singh. Yes. All of you. And now this is the link for the WhatsApp group. Okay. So what we are going to do today is, you all, whomsoever wants to participate, has to get into this WhatsApp group. Of course, you have to subscribe to our YouTube channel as well, right? Subscribe to get into this WhatsApp group. This the link has been shared. And the next thing will be, I'll be giving you the topics. Okay, lecturate, as you know, is the second task of the confirmatory series. You will get, I'll give you the topics. You will get 3 minutes to prepare on that topic. Okay. Thereafter, spontaneously, immediately after you select the topic, now all of you can select one topic each, right? Even if it is duplicated, doesn't matter. You select the topic, prepare for 3 minutes, right? And वो आप 3 मिनट तक आप अलग से वो कर सकते हो. यू कैन टेक ऑफ फ्रॉम द क्लास, प्रिपेयर सेपरेटली आफ्टर 3 मिनट्स, रिकॉर्ड दिस इन योर मोबाइल व्हाट्सएप, राइट, इन योर वॉइस रिकॉर्डर, एंड देन ट्रांसमिट इट ऑन टू द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप दैट यू हैव जस्ट जॉइंड. इज दैट क्लियर? So these are the topics for the lecture 8. Okay, let me first, let me just give you some sample. Okay, so in my institute, I do conduct these classes as well, right? So I'll just try and play something for you. So that is not exactly a demo lecture 8, ठीक है? But you know, definitely it'll give you some kind of a clue how to speak, how not to speak, what to do, what not to do, right? Okay, so I'm just trying to play this. I hope now we are able to succeed. And tech support, are you there? Bipin?
Basically, WebSphere countries are the countries who are basically surrounding the Bay of Bengal. Bay of Bengal is another important stretch between India and Myanmar, which is an ocean body which is as helpful, as essential as maybe
Japan,
America, maybe. Bay of Bengal, WebSphere, initially, WebSphere, the full form of WebSphere is Bay of Bengal Initiative for Multisectoral and multi-sectoral technological and economical cooperation. The members of BIMSTEC are India, Nepal, Bhutan, Thailand, Myanmar and Sri Lanka. The BIMSTEC was formed just basically to avert the situation which happened in South China Sea because of the dominance of China. China initially has the objective of creating naval bases surrounding the blockades and also influencing the trade of that particular region, as happened in South China Sea. India took the initiative in 1990s to initiate this program of BIMSTEC. Earlier it was known as on the initials of the country, but later the name was changed and the full form was changed. Currently, the establishment has tie-ups with ADB, that is Asian Developmental Bank, and World Bank, and World Trade Organization. The BIMSTEC is essentially formulated in order to ease up the trade, and there is a free trade area or free trade zone created apart from the maintenance of exclusive economic zone and the developmental procedures for the cooperative trade. For example, the recent Rohpur thermal power plant was created with the common collective of Bangladesh, India and Russia in Bangladesh, but it had to take clearance from the BIMSTEC and from the SCO, that is Shanghai Cooperation Organization, in order for it to be stipulated and formulated, and thereby it was essentially given a loan from ADB and the World Bank, and which had to be repaid, and also Bangladesh had to deposit a particular token amount in the SCO and BIMSTEC. This is necessary because it averts the superpowers like US, Russia or China to create any kind of direct influence in a region which is not theirs. Thereby, China had been kept at par and not a member of BIMSTEC. These member nations also have annual meetings which are called the summits, and the four-yearly, quad-yearly meetings which have happened. The last meeting was in Kathmandu, and the agenda was to discuss the counter-terrorism operations between this Bay of Bengal region, especially the pirates and the piracy that happens, and the trade of illegal trade of livestock, and apart from that, Rohingya issue was also discussed. In my opinion, BIMSTEC and SCO and other associations like this is very important and facilitates the cooperative growth, cooperative development and the collective responsibility of the region, because it is divided into sectors, so particular country takes part of the particular area of the region that is present. thereby giving accountability and responsibility.
Okay. So we are just trying to, you know, I'm just trying to give you as real a scenario as possible. There are technical limitations, I understand, but we are trying to, you know, get better of them. Okay, so gradually we will move, and I'll try and give you close to real-time experience, right? I understand, yes, uploading the video does take time. So let us see, you know, how we move forward. So have you been able to get some video? Have you been able to see the guy who has been speaking? Could you see the speaker? Okay, now these are your topics. Okay, these are the instructions for participation. Join Train for SSB YouTube WhatsApp group. Okay, technical support. Please share it once again. Those of you who have not been able to log on. Okay, second task of confirmatory series, 3 minutes to prepare. Okay, when I say go, that means you select a topic, take 3 minutes to prepare, 3 minutes to speak and record in your mobile voice recorder. Okay, then send it on Train for SSB YT, that is YouTube group. Okay. Entries received first will be played for debrief. Clear? Instructions clear? Any doubts? Any doubts on the instructions? Any questions, any doubts as far as the instructions are there? Are you able to see the slide? Are you able to see the slide? Okay, good. Okay, now I am giving you the topics. Okay, time now is 3 p.m. Select any one topic. Okay, topics are 1, 2, 3, 4. Tell me who all have selected 1. Who all have selected 1? Okay, against your name, write which topic you have selected. Please write down which topic you have selected. Okay, topic, you're not able to see the thing, is it? Okay, the first topic is salary cut amid COVID-19. There was a news yesterday that there has been a cut in salary of the parliamentarians, the president, the governors, vice president, 30% cut. Okay, so salary cut amid COVID-19. Okay, the second topic is CAA. Third topic is social responsibility of citizens amid COVID-19. I repeat, third topic, social responsibility of citizens amid COVID-19. Fourth topic, women in combat arms. Repeat, fourth topic, women in combat arms. Please write them down and then let me know which topic you are going to speak on. First topic, salary cut amid COVID-19. Second topic, CAA. I do not know, you choose because this is going to be live. Okay. अभी जो है आपको टाइम मिला दिया जा रहा है 3 मिनट. आप फ्रेश प्रिपेयर करो एंड उसके बाद में रिकॉर्ड करके फॉरवर्ड इट ऑन द सेम व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप. इज दैट क्लियर? नो, यू हैव टू चूज एनी वन टॉपिक. Any one topic you are comfortable with. Any topic. Even if you have done it earlier, no problems. The idea is just to see, you know, how is the process going. Okay. And there will be no editing. Whatever, you know, 3 minutes you prepare, I am not going to, you know, give you those 2.5 minutes warning, etc. I leave it to you. When I say go, that time, please go ahead and start. Okay. Those who have chosen the first two topics, salary cut and CAA, who have to chosen first two topics, salary cut and CAA. Okay, the first two topics, these people can start now. Third and fourth topic, those who have chosen social responsibility and women in combat arms, please hold on. Okay. So only first two topics jisne choose kiya hai, they can start preparing for 3 minutes. And after 3 minutes, please send your audio file on the same WhatsApp group, right? Okay, so those who are yet to start preparing, please hold on. Okay, I'll let you know when to start. Okay. Now, in the previous this thing, when I was playing this a recorded lecturate, were you able to see the video? Rahul and Sumedh, were you able to see the video jo maine pehle diya tha? Usme, there was one guy speaking on BIMSTEC. That is just a sample video, okay. No, you are not able to see that.
को आ रहा है
तो मेरे पास नहीं आ रहा। आकर्षण का लेक्चर था, वीडियो आया था पूरा। ओके ओके, बिकॉज मेरे को नहीं दिखाई दे रहा, चलो देखता हूँ। राइट, ओके, ओके, इन द न्यू ग्रुप ट्रेन फॉर SSB YT मोनिका, ओके, द लिंक इज डिस्प्लेड इन द चैट। Okay, so those of you who have been able to see that, okay, so I have received from two of the candidates, Bishnu and Monica. Okay, so I'll be playing these now. Okay, so I've received it from Bishnu and Monica. So I'll be playing this. In the meantime, the next group who have selected topic 3 and 4, Okay, got it? Clear? Yeah, Monica, you are in the first group. So I'll be playing these things now. No, yours as well as Vishnu's. Okay, now the instructions are for the second group who have chosen third and fourth topic, right? The third and fourth group can now start preparing. I think there is a delay, right? Okay, Vishnu, are you there? Vishnu, Monica, who all are there, please raise your hands. Who all are there listening, other than those who are preparing? Okay. Yes, Rahul, you can go. You are in the second group. You can go. You can start preparing. I think there is a there's quite a lag. Yes, Sumedh, you can also go. You can start preparing. Sumedh, Rahul, all those in the second group.
Salaries by 30%, and most of the central government employees have decided to give one day salary for the COVID-19 fund. Friends, this time is a difficult time for us. COVID-19 is a pandemic disease which has taken more than 70,000 lives all over the world and has already infected more than 30 lakh people around the world. In India also, the disease is spreading very fast, and we must put all our efforts together to fight the disease. So, how the salary cut can help to fight COVID-19? As we know, we need fund to support the economy. Already, since last 20 days, the economy shut down, and that many people are not having work, so they should be provided the work. In fact, not work, they should provide the money. This salary cut at least helps in doing those work. Also, there's a huge economy package is given by the government, and for the salary cut will be a little step towards not overburdening the exchequer. As our economy is shut down, so there is no growth. So the burden on the economy will reduce definitely if there is a little salary cut. And not only apart from this, for the informal sector, for whom their daily wage salary is the only help to live the life. For them, it is going to be affected very harshly. So for them, at least government can provide the support to the companies to pay the salary to the workers. That can help to meet the challenges of salary cut. Friends, this is a difficult time and we must fight it together, and every strength of us should be used to fight COVID-19. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Bishnu. So you all have listened to that? Have you all listened to what Bishnu has spoken? Right, so the time taken by Bishnu has been 2 minutes 56 seconds. So time management wise, it is good. Then he has been able to quote some certain figures, okay, 30% cut and the kind of, you know, various other facts that he has mentioned, certain statistics that he has mentioned. So that is a good thing, which indicates the general awareness of the candidate is good. Okay, the confidence level is satisfactory, quite satisfactory, I would say. However, now that, you know, it is a real-time lecturate, the flow of talk has not been as fluent as it was when, you know, Bishnu had prepared the topics and then sent the audio. Bishnu, am I right? Okay. Sumant Lohi, have you forwarded? What was your topic? Okay, so the next person is Monica.
Article 14, which deals with right of equality, and also this law is anti-Muslim law. But
government clarify on this point that Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh are Islamic countries where Muslims are in majority, hence they cannot be treated as suppressed minority, which is actually correct. Second, by the people of Northeast India, they feel that it will change the demography of Northeast India. Their actual concern with the illegal Bengali Hindus migrant from Bangladesh. This law excludes Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Mizoram, Meghalaya and some tribal parts of Assam and Tripura. Thank you.
Okay guys, so Monica was there on Citizenship Amendment Act. The figures that she's been quoting, the kind of, you know, amendments, the when the law was initially made, and you know, over the period of time in different years, how things have altered. Okay, so all this information that she's been able to quote, that is really good. Though I personally feel that it is some kind of a prepared speech. So one can be lucky, you know, if you can get some prepared topic, because extempore, I am not very sure whether one would, you know, be able to speak with these kind of facts and figures. So, but anyway, as I see it from here, the content has been good. Okay, the confidence is okay. Right, and Monica, I think there is some kind of yeah, to aisa lag raha hai ki aapki saans phool rahi hai beech mein, right? You are a singer, you know, you should be able to probably, you know, speak without, you know, resorting to these heavy breaths. Aisa mehsoos ho raha hai, but I think, you know, you can improve this further, right? Time management has been okay to 3 minutes, 1 second. Okay, that is what your, this thing has been there. And so congratulations, all of you, for having, you know, recorded the thing and sent it in quick time. Yes, so Vishnu, that's right. सो देखो जब लाइव आप बोलते हो तो ये सारी चीज़ें आती हैं नो, वैसे हम सोचते हैं कि हम आराम से बोल लेंगे, बट व्हेन यू आर एक्चुअली यू नो गोइंग टू स्पीक, सो दीज थिंग्स विल अकर, राइट? एंड एज यू हैड सीन, यू नो, व्हेन आई हैड प्लेड दैट सैम्पल वीडियो ऑफ लेक्चर 8, सो द गाय हु वाज स्पीकिंग, नो, ही वाज वेरी कॉन्फिडेंट, हिज पोस्चर, आई वुड लाइक यू टू मॉनिटर, ओके, जो मैंने आपको एक वीडियो दिखाया था, दैट पोस्चर वॉज वेरी गुड, द एक्सप्रेशंस वो वेरी गुड, आर्टिकुलेशन वॉज गुड, कॉन्फिडेंस वॉज गुड, ओनली थिंग, यू नो, ही वॉज अ लिटल फास्ट, ही वॉज नॉट एबल टू, यू नो, रिमेंबर एवरीथिंग, देन ही हैड टू रिसोर्ट टू लुकिंग एट द बोर्ड फॉर द टॉपिक, ओके, बट overall I would like you to emulate the kind of body posture that he was displaying, all right? Otherwise I think rest was fine, and you will find that jaise jaise aap apne aap bol rahe ho yahan pe in real time, okay, you will keep improving definitely. Okay, next is Rahul.
Good afternoon everyone. Today I'll be talking about women in combat arms. So as we know, last year, Lieutenant Bhavna Kasturi led an all-male contingent in Republic Day Parade. And this year, Captain Tania Shergill led an all-male contingent in Army Day Parade. Then Flight Lieutenant Bhavna Kant has become the first female Indian Air Force pilot to qualify to undertake combat missions on a fighter jet. And after all this, Supreme Court has also ordered the center to ensure that women officers in Indian Army should be granted permanent commission as well as certain command positions. So this all is not happening abruptly. The role of women in combat arms goes way back in 19th century, when in 1857, Rani Lakshmibai, the Queen of Jhansi, led a rebellion against Britishers, uttering those historic words, "Main apni Jhansi nahi dungi." and several other women with the weapons in their hand standing by the side of Rani to fight against the Britishers for their freedom. Then in 1942, when the Indian National Army was taken over by the Subhash Chandra Bose, he also raised an all-women combat infantry for the fighting against the Britishers. Subhash Chandra Bose himself said that he has named this infantry as Rani Jhansi Regiment because he has read an article by an Englishman that said if there were 1,000 women like Rani, we could have never conquered India. After all this, it took around 50 years for the Officers Training Academy to open its doors for the women cadets for short service commission. And in 2008, the service of women short service commission was made equal to the main short service commission. So it took this much time because the social barriers that our Indian society had, that the minds of people had in India. But now I think those barriers are removed from the people's mind to a larger extent, and if there are still some of it remaining, it will be removed very soon looking at the present scenario. Thank you very much.
Okay, so that was Rahul, and Rahul, I think you deserve appreciation. You've spoken with poise, with confidence. The speed with which you have spoken is just the right kind of speed, not too slow, not too fast. Okay, and obviously your the facts and the information, the content has been quite rich. Okay, so overall a very good performance, right? So thank you. I think the next, let's play Sanam.
Good afternoon, guys. My name is Sanam Singh, and the topic for my lecture is Citizenship Amendment Act 2019. Citizenship lies in the second part of the Constitution, ranges from Article 5 to Article 11. There has been multiple amendments done in previously in to provide citizenship to various people. But the Citizenship Amendment Act 2019 is the legislation which will amend the Citizenship Amendment Act 1955. This act proposes granting the Indian citizenship to persecuted minorities as such as Hindus, Jains, Christians, Sikhs, Buddhists and Parsis fleeing from Bangladesh, Pakistan and Afghanistan. The legislation seeks to make it easier for non-Muslim refugees and illegal immigrants from three Islamic nations as mentioned before. The legislation is applicable to groups who have arrived in India on or before 31st December 2014. That means the cutoff date set by the central government is 31st December 2014. Under the Citizenship Amendment Act 1955, one of the requirements to give citizenship was by naturalization, is that the applicant must be resided in India during the last 12 months as well as 11 of the previous 14 years. The amendment relaxes the second requirement from 11 years to 6 years as a specific condition for applicants belonging to six religion and belonging to the three nations. There is some exceptions given by the central government, that is there has been wide protest from northeastern states. So northeastern states have been exempted from Citizenship Amendment Act, lying those states lying in Schedule 6 and ILP, that is Inner Line Permit. Tribal areas of Assam, Meghalaya, Mizoram or Tripura, these are included in 6th schedule, and Inner Line Permit, that is Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram and Nagaland. The basic issues which is there in the act is the fundamental criticism of the bill that it specifically targets Muslims, and critics also argue that it is the violation of Article 14, that is equality, right to equality, and it should guarantee it. But the government, however, maintains the will and aims that to grant citizenship to minorities who have faced religious persecution in Muslim-majority foreign nations. Government has also said that citizenship will be as usual. If anyone being from other nation wants to take citizenship, they can apply for it. Thank you.
Okay, Sanam, I think again your lectorate is full of information, so that is something very good. Time management has been okay, a little overshooting by about 11 seconds, 3 minutes, 11 seconds you have taken. So just remember ki time management is important, okay? Aapko last mein jo hai, aisa nahi hona chahiye ki the GTO has to cut you short and then you are not able to probably finish your punchline. And I am yet waiting for that punchline to start coming. Okay, so that is it. Overall, Sanam, I think a good performance. The next time we practice this, we will have one more of this, and I would be giving those topics, something that you perhaps would not have come across, so that extempore aap kitna achi tarah se bol sakte ho without preparation. Now all these topics that we have been talking about, we have already discussed during our classes, right? So isme abhi jo hai, there is no element of surprise. So the moment there is some element of surprise, we will find that asli chehra samne aaye. Theek hai? Okay, so but anyway, I am very happy that you people are able to express yourself pretty well. Theek hai? So good. Okay, next is Hemant.
Hello friends, today I'm talking on the topic of social responsibility of citizens amid coronavirus 19. So we know that the coronavirus has been originated from China and now spread all over the country. 206 countries have been affected by coronavirus, and especially more than 60% of the people who have been affected with coronavirus is from Europe. And we know that nations like Italy, France, Spain and America are hugely affected with the coronavirus 19. As part of that, our country has launched a lockdown, and currently we are going through a lockdown process. So to fight against the coronavirus, it's important that each and every citizen should be socially and morally responsible. In order to follow the law and order which have been put forward by the government, which will ensure the social distancing, by the way, we can destroy the spreading of coronavirus from one individual to another individual. In India itself, we know that more than 4,000 people have been infected with coronavirus, and out of that, now more than 100 people are also have been suffered death due to the coronavirus infection. So until in our country at presently, we were not able to prevent the virus from spreading into a community level. That means the wide and mass spreading of coronavirus, we were able to prevent it until a level, and it's our responsibility to follow the orders so that we could completely eliminate the presence of coronavirus from our country within a few weeks. So the spreading of the coronavirus is through to touch and air. So it's important to keep hygiene and also the social distancing, which means we should be able to keep ourselves distant from a crowd, forming a crowd or other relatives or friends or anyone who know. So we should by law, what does it
हाँ विपिन, अच्छा क्या यार बीच बीच नहीं, अभी तो मैंने बंद कर दिया है। हाँ नहीं कर दिया तो मैंने, आई थिंक दैट इज या अच्छा अच्छा हाँ नहीं कर दिया मैंने, अच्छा अच्छा ओके, हाँ हाँ बंद कर दो बंद कर।